I'm Justin Davis, and this is Drone Camps RC.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Justin Davis. Check out what I have here for you today. This is a 90mm Q90, and it seems like there's been a lot of Q90s on the channel recently. Everybody's choosing this Q90 name, but this one looks pretty similar to the one I reviewed yesterday on the channel. You saw that if you did watch that one, it had a failed part. The bottom plate broke, but this is a completely different animal. It's a thicker bottom plate on here. I believe it's 2mm bottom plate with 3K carbon fiber weave on the bottom, and it looks like it's at about a 45 degree angle, which is great for strength and rigidity in the frame. Also has that same aluminum anodized top plate on here protecting camera, and it looks like a Runcam micro style camera. If we look at this from the side, you can see that camera in there. It is 700 TVL, and it also has an Omnibus F3 flight controller on here, which most of you guys know is very, very easy to fly and very tunable, very easy to get going right out of beta flight on the default PID. So that's super cool. Another highlight of this guy is it runs from 2 to 3S. So if you want to rock some 3S on this guy, I upgraded this JST. It was a red one on here, and I upgraded it to an XT30. So that's going to give it better punch. If you get this quad, it's around $100 plug and play. I would definitely suggest upgrading to this one. It makes a huge difference in power punch out and performance on this quad. It just night and day difference between JST and this XT30. This is gonna be a little more of a hot rod for you. If you're new, start out with the JST and then move up to the XT30 connector. I also got the NoRX version, and I put an FR Sky XM transmitter on here, and that's working pretty nice for a full range micro receiver. And this quad also has GT 1104 7500 kV motors on here, so I was expecting good park performance out of this quad, and I was not let down by that. And this little guy weighs about 60 grams, so it's very, very light, probably around the 95 gram mark with a 2S battery on there, so just around 100 grams total takeoff weight is not bad. Now, it also has OSD on here, and you can go in beta flight. It has 3.1 on here. You can change up everything you see on the screen, and you can customize that, add your own pilot name and all that cool stuff using your laptop. It's pretty easy to set up, but it also shows you your battery telemetry and voltage and what flight mode you're in. It's also kind of nice. Also, the flight time. If you want to put a timer on your radio and also see it on the screen, you can do that as well. Now, it is compatible with DSM-2, Spectrum, and PPM receivers. So if you also want to put an S-Bus one down there like I have here, you can also do that. Now, this one didn't come with a battery in the box, but it did come with two sets of these props, and I did break a couple of them. They're not the best props, so I would say maybe that's one disadvantage of this quad, is that the props, they're a little bit plasticky feeling. So I'm looking for a better quality prop coming from this company, whichever one this is, because there's no name on this one. It just says Q90, no RX, and that's pretty much it. It was bare bones in the box, but I had this one flying in about 10 minutes, which is nice because it was already set up on the motors. The motor directions were all correct right out of beta flight. I didn't have to go into BL Heli and do any reversing of any of the motors. Now, as far as your video transmitter goes, you have a pretty nice transmitter on this one. This is the Q150 video transmitter, and it does switchable option between 25 milliwatt and 150 milliwatt. So 150 on a micro is pretty good. I'd like to see 200 as always, but hey, I'll take 150 over 25 any day. Now, my suggested battery for this one, I'm going to put a link down below, would be a 2 to 3S battery in the 500 milliamp range. And a tip for you guys, when you get this one, if you decide to take it out on your maiden, the first day you take it out, go ahead and put a little zip tie right here on this bottom rail and put it right around this power cable. So when your battery gets pulled, or if your battery gets ripped off this quad at any time, when it pulls on this cord right here, it's not pulling on where it connects to the ESCs inside there, because there's two little tabs in there, and these can get ripped off really easily. And if the two metal tabs come off of the back of your ESC right there, you're pretty much gonna have to get a new ESC 4-in-1 stack there, and you're gonna have to replace that. So most definitely put yourself a zip tie right here where I have mine. You might be able to see it if I get it to go in focus right there. So this is a quad that I can get behind and I can recommend, because it flew pretty good out there on 2S, and on 3S it was a ball to fly. So around the $100 range with this punky little sort of football helmet shell over the top of the whole stack. Everything's pretty well protected, and the camera, harness in here is actually easily adjustable. So, and the Runcam style camera, rocking 700 TVL. It's a pretty decent camera on there. So let's go outside now. Let's do some line of sight flight tests with this. Then we'll do some FPV with this little Q90. Pretty cool little quad.
All right, here we go with some 2S action line of sight. It's still pretty peppy with this XT30 on here. It really makes a big difference from the JST. And don't be scared to switch this out to an XT30 because it does have 15 amp ESC on here. So 4-in-1 ESC, so no big deal. It can handle it. And these 1104s can handle it. Actually flies a lot better than when I had the JST on there. So here we go. Let's do a little FPV. I think this is pretty cool. Actually, a lot less wobble on 2S, so it just needs two separate tunes, and you can save those two different profiles inside Betaflight for your 2S tune and your 3S tune. Here we go.